वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर फॉर इम्पिरिकल रिसर्च मेथड इन HCI एंड इट्स रिलेटेड टू यूनिट 4. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज ऑलरेडी वी हैव लर्न अबाउट इवोल्यूशन मेथड सच एज ह्यूरिस्टिक इवोल्यूशन, कॉग्निटिव वॉक थ्रूज और कॉग्निटिव मॉडल्स टू इवोल्यूट डिजाइन एट द अर्ली फेजेस. एंड we already mentioned interactive system design is not complete unless it is evaluated with end users. So end user is important here. And here we shall learn about user evaluation methods. Okay, so we will learn about like the key concern in user evaluation, second data collection procedures, and third data analysis techniques. So empirical research is broadly defined as the observation-based investigation seeking to discover and interpret facts, theories, or laws, and it is basically a observation study. Okay, so collection and analysis of end-user data for determining usability of an interactive system is an observation-based investigation. And it is qualified, hence it is qualifies as empirical research. So themes of empirical research, first generally speaking about empirical research there are three themes. Okay, it has three themes. First, answer and raise question about a new or existing UI design or interaction method. Second, observe and measure. And third, user studies. So we will learn about these three themes. So first, research questions. So it is very important in an empirical research to formulate appropriate research questions. Okay, like here example, you can see is it viable, okay, or feasible, or you can say useful, okay, and is it as good as or better than current practice, okay, better than old systems, okay. And third, which of several design alternative is best, okay, there are lots of designs, and which is the best to identify according to this research questions. Okay, so research question are very important. It is very important in an empirical research to formulate appropriate research questions. And you can see some examples here. What are its performance limits and capabilities, first, okay. Second, what are its strengths and weaknesses, and third, how much practice is required to become proficient. So these questions help to make a good empirical research. Now, testable research question. Preceding questions, while unquestionably relevant, are not testable. Okay, and we have to come up with testable questions in empirical research to get the final output. So, testable research questions. Here is an example. Suppose you have designed a new text entry technique for mobile phones, and you think the design is good. And in fact, you feel your method is better than most widely used current techniques and multi-tap. Okay, and you decide to undertake some empirical research to evaluate your inventions and to compare it with multi-tap. So what are your research questions? So here are some questions. So weak questions like, is the new technique better than multi-tap? Okay, and the better question is the new technique faster than multi-tap? And better still, is the new technique faster than multi-tap within 1 hour of use? Okay, so you can see here different types of questions and their effects. Okay, so testable research questions even better, like if error rates are kept under 2%, is the new technique faster than multi-tap within 1 hour of use? This is the better question, and the questions are testable because here is some data related to its performance. Okay, so we can actually conduct experiment to test the answer to the question. And then वी कैन आस्क वेरी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चंस, ओके, लाइक लास्ट वन, और रिलेटिवली ब्रॉड क्वेश्चंस लाइक फर्स्ट वन. एंड फॉर वेरी स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द आंसर इज हाई, वेयर एज फॉर ब्रॉडर क्वेश्चन द ब्रीथ और जनरलिटी इज हाई. सो क्वेश्चंस हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट इफेक्ट्स एंड प्रायोरिटीज, ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू नीड दे आर यूज्ड इन एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च. देन हियर यू कैन सी ए ग्राफ लाइक ग्राफ बिटवीन ब्रीथ ऑफ क्वेश्चन एंड एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द आंसर्स. So if error rates are kept under 2% is the new technique faster than multi-tap within 1 hour of use. So your graph goes high, okay, for accuracy of answers. And for the broader question, is the new technique better than multi-tap? So the accuracy of answer is low, okay. So accuracy of answer also used for internal validity, okay. And breadth of questions related to external validity. So it makes the empirical research better for better results. And internal and external validity, here the extent to which the effects observed are due to the test condition is called internal validity of the research question. Okay, so effects are observed here, okay. And the second, the extent to which results are generalizable to other people's and other situation is known as the external validity of the research question. So how the other people's react according to that generalized questions and other conditions also important in the external validity of research question. And more example on validity, like suppose you wish to compare two input devices for remote pointing at a projection screen, for example. And internal validity is improved if the test environment mimics expected uses, okay. So the test environment should use a projection screen simply, and position participants at a significant distance from the screen, and have participants stand and include an audience. So it's just like an experiment, okay, real one experiment, real life a real experiment, okay. And note here that creating the test environment mimicking the real user scenario is not easy, okay. Always we cannot mimic the real life situations, okay. So instead you can go for controlled experiment where you can ask the user to sit in front of a computer in a laboratory and use the pointing devices to operate an application on the screen. And so like this, the above setting can answer research question with high internal validity but can not help in determining if the answers are applicable in real world. So situations are different because mimicking the real life is not easy, and the controlled experiment not provide the proper research, or you can say result, okay. So more like examples on validity, like consider another scenario where you wish to compare two text entry technique for mobile devices. And to improve external validity, the test procedure should require participant to enter representative sample of text, okay. You have to enter some text and phrases containing letters, numbers, punctuation, etc., and then correct mistakes. So this may require compromising on internal validity, okay. So because there are some different scenario here, and normally some trade-offs related to this internal external validity are there is a tension between internal and external validity. The more the test environment experimental procedures are relaxed, the more the experiments is susceptible to do uncontrolled sources of variation such as pointing directions or secondary tasks. So both have different effects. So resolving this trade-off, the internal external validity are increased by posing multiple narrow testable questions that cover the range of outcome influencing the broader untestable questions. Like here, a technique that is faster, is more accurate, takes fewer steps, is easy to learn and is easy to remember, is generally better. And again, the good news is that there is a usually a positive correlation between the testable and untestable questions. And here example, participant generally find a UI better if it is faster, more accurate, takes fewer steps, etc. And the good news, in fact, is not so good after all, as it raises more confusion. Okay, so you can see here some different details. So that's so next is implication. Okay, so implication, the good news actually implies we do not need empirical research. Okay, so we just do a user study. Okay, according to user requirement, and ask participants which techniques they preferred, and because of the positive correlation, we need not take the pain in collecting and analyzing data. Okay, simply we ask participants which techniques are better to use. Okay, so if participants are asked which technique they prefer, like a broad questions, they will probably give an answer, and even if they really have no particular preference, so there is some confusion, and there are many reasons, such as how recently they were tested on a technique, personal interaction with the experimenter, or etc. Okay, so basically this is not true always, and therefore such preferences need not be indicative of the system performance. So we need to scientifically ascertain the validity of the preferences expressed by the participants and which requires formulation of testable questions. That's why we need testable questions for our empirical research. And also with broader question, we may not get idea about the feasibility and usefulness of the system. Already we know that, and so it is not enough to know if the system is better than another system only, but we also need to know how much better. Okay, we need performance related some data or criteria. Okay, so you can see here some example. Okay, it may not be feasible economically to develop a system that is only 5% better than the current system. We need better systems. And then seeking feedback from users on broader questions is not very helpful from another perspective, and it does not help to identify the strengths, weaknesses, limits, capabilities of the design, and thereby making it difficult to identify opportunities for improvements. So we need some more details, and such concerns can be addressed only with the raising of testable research questions that provide good data. Okay, and good information or performance related to the system or data. Okay, using testable research question. An important point is to note is in order to test the validity of research question through observation, we need measurements. So this brings us to the second theme of empirical research, namely to observe and measure. So today I will only stop here. Okay, so next time we will discuss about observe and measure. So first you learn about this testable research questions, and then how to use them. Okay, and again you will study about this normal questions, like you can say observable questions. Okay, and then you can study about this testable research questions, and you can make your own example and questions using this empirical research methods. So next class we will study about observe and measures. So that's all for today's class. Thank you.